Hi and welcome to my channel. Today I have a jelly printing video for you and I am printing in two small art journals. I started this a while ago and I really enjoyed doing it and I love to have a book full of jelly prints and lovely backgrounds. The first prints are done with pen pastels on the jelly plate. There is a how-to video available over on my Instagram exclusive page, and today I'm going to make some more jelly prints. I have two books because then I can alternate to let each page dry before I can print the next one. And here I have a stack of jelly prints that I'm going to use to clean my brayer. I like to have the backside also colored. And I will also use some of our stencils to make the patterns. The books I'm using are sketchbooks from Kunst und Papier, that's a German manufacturer, I believe. And the paper has 130 GSM. It is a drawing paper and it is, I would say, a little bit off-white, not much, and it has some really fine texture, not much, so it's great for jelly printing. The paints I'm using are the Amsterdam paints and some from Schmincke, and maybe I will also use the paints gray from Le Franc et Bourgeois. These are my go-to paints when I do jelly printing. As I had so much fun with this book printing, I bought the same sketchbooks in an A4 size and I already started printing them, and I will definitely make a video for those as well. I love the bigger papers, and I'm using my super big jelly plate, which is a bit bigger than A4 to print in these A4 sketchbooks, and that gives me full size prints, and it's so nice to flip through them. I am working intuitively as always. I have no plan usually when I do jelly printing. I just go with the flow and enjoy the process. As I always have some space that is not covered, I'm using papers that I want to fill, and I just lay them on top of my page so I don't get dirty fingers and I don't waste any paint. Making this with the papers gives me also some really nice patchworky prints, which are great for card making or artist trading cards, and also to use as pages in an art journal. And here you can see I'm alternating between the books, so every time the page has a little bit time to dry, and I can print in the other book, and so it's quite easy to print both sides. I picked these sketchbooks for jelly printing because I had those laying around for over a year and I didn't use them. I planned to use them as an art journal, but then I just didn't like the size of them. And then I decided I just will use them and make jelly prints. I would not buy that square format again because it just doesn't fill a lot of the space. I think about buying another A5 landscape one. So with the bigger jelly plate I have, I could print two prints at the same time with the A5 size. But as I now have that square one, I will fill it But I would not buy this format again because it's just, it does not make much sense for me because it does not fit the jelly plate. Before I go on top with a next layer of paint, I will let this dry a little bit. Not 100% because that just takes up so much time and I don't have the patience to wait each time to let everything dry on my plate. I want to create and have fun, and so I just wait a little bit so I can make sure that it does not smear completely when I go on top with a second layer. I also try to work with complementary colors on the second layer. Here I picked that turquoise. It's complementary against that burnt sienna I already have on my page. I also often mix in or use some light colors as a second layer, so I don't dull down the first layer. Here I'm experimenting and I just go in with another stencil image to create a lot of texture. I do not clean my stencils when I do jelly printing because it gives only a thin layer of paint on the stencil and I just live with that. It's fine for me. If you don't like cleaning your stencils and you don't want to have them dirty, I recommend my latest YouTube video about jelly printing. I posted it 2 weeks ago, and there I use a new technique where you use your stencils but you don't make them dirty. So you might want to check that out. I will link it up in the end cards and also in the video description. I'm really looking forward to when the books are full and finished. I think I will not grab any of these papers before they are done. Don't know why, maybe that's kind of weird, but I can't wait to flip through them. And of course, as soon as I have filled one of these, I will make a flip through. Not sure if I will share it on YouTube, but for sure on my Instagram page. Or maybe you will let me know if you would love to watch this on YouTube or if you don't mind if it's on Instagram or on YouTube. Well, I think it might be a bit quick to flip through the whole book in 1 minute. We will see. I feel this is quite a boring print, but I often reach for those simple prints more than for the colorful ones, especially when I do collage. I always try to use the time whilst the pattern is drying a bit to brayer over the stencils, clean the brayer on the paper, and just think about which colors I wanted to use next. This big ovals stencil is one of my favorites for jelly printing. I think it's so simple, but it makes a wonderful background. What also looks really nice is when you dry emboss some paper with it. There is a tutorial on our shop blog how to do this with your Big Shot, and then you can use it as a card background. This stencil is also one of my favorites. It's the organic number 3. And it reminds me a lot about ocean waves or about a desert, maybe with some sand dunes. And I did already some nice prints with it, but I haven't used them. But I think I will use them for some summer ocean-themed cards in the future. There was a bit too much of that Payne's Gray on the page, and I decided to just pick that up with one of my leftover or cleaning papers. I really love how this turned out. It's kind of an underwater or ocean themed background with some really interesting texture of the paint's gray. And I also like that there are often some leftover speckles on the prints from previous printings. And that's what I really like. By the way, I'm using not white as my light color. I always use colors like Titan Buff, Light and Dark, or some Naples Yellow, reddish or greenish from Amsterdam, because these are quite light but not white, and I feel that looks often better than using a pure white color. That is also not much of a texture. I like it anyway, but I think I maybe will try to use a more opaque color in the future when I use a light one. And here I'm working with the Payne's Gray again. I recently did some really nice grungy prints with some black, and I will definitely try this out in my next YouTube video. In my next jelly printing video, which will be for sure printing in the bigger journals, I think, because I can't wait to get them filled up with beautiful papers. That is funny now because the stencil gets almost clean or half clean by just rayering it onto that paper, and that gave a really interesting textured pattern here. For my last print, I decided to just clean off the jelly plate. There are often a lot of fragments and textures from the previous prints on the plate, which often create some interesting backgrounds. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and it might be another jelly printing video next week, maybe with some Halloween backgrounds. I wish you a lovely weekend. Bye.